Hello, everyone. It's Delana Graytuttle, aka Gray Overcast, and today's watercolor painting is going to be of Sissieretta Jones. She was a singer back in the 1800s. Actually, before I get some of that pencil off. She was a singer in the 1800s that received countless awards. She was the first Black singer to headline in Carnegie Hall. And she was just really successful. But she was also forgotten, which is unfortunate. She doesn't have any recordings of her voice, so we don't know what she sounded like. But she was a soprano. And like most artists of her time, she ended up penniless. She stopped everything to go help her mother. Her mother was sick, so she helped her. And luckily, she was successful because they lived off of her wealth that she accumulated. Sorry for my creaky floor. I'm in a different area today. I'm at my kitchen table. Sorry, not kitchen table. I consider it my kitchen table, but it's the dining room. The kitchen's like right there, but dining room table. And I'm standing up. I usually kind of lean against the couch. But my dog didn't like me on the couch, so I moved here and he seems to be okay with it because he was like, I'm going upstairs. Which usually he's, if you've seen past traditional art streams, he'll just be barking in the grunt background. So I don't really have a color scheme. I kind of do, kind of don't. It's just whatever is here. Thinking purple, maybe muted purple. There goes my cat acting up. She's on the coffee table. And I just, I want to make a dark background. Like I said, I'm kind of winging it, so. See that? Get some more red in there. I'm fairly new to watercolor. I've been doing it for a couple of years. Over here, he's playing with the pencils. If you can see that, that's from having cheap brushes, which, you know, use what you can use. What is there? What you can afford. It's not one as the other, seriously. Forgot about her shawl. Kind of too late, but I'll lift some of it up. And it's also International Women's Day. Happy International Women's Day. It's too late. That's okay. Maybe not. Just blow drying the first layer. Oops. The fingerprint. Top on the bottom. With watercolor, you kind of let it do what it wants to, kind of. You wet the area you want. The color to go on it, and then by controlled chaos. I might use, oops, sorry. I might use colored pencil later if there's time. Yeah, I messed up there, but we'll try to fix it. And my watercolors today are Core, QOR, Core. I believe that's how you pronounce it. Daniel Smith, and I might also use, oh, hold on one moment. I might bonus guns things. Dog was playing with something he should not have been playing with. One of my bonus son's toys, or I don't know, something from his skateboard, probably. I'll wet it again. And my dog's name is Marshmallow. I don't think I said that. He's a cutie. He's a American pit mix, American bulldog mix. And actually, I should have left some white marks here, but I can add it in later. I'll probably. This is why you should. Plan out your paintings first. But sometimes I like to just wing it, see what happens. You know, that's fun too. In the reference photo, she has this boa. I use this guy as my. I use paper towels. I use these. I don't know what they're called, but they're like washcloths, but they're good for drying too. Come from the dollar store or TJ Maxx. I don't know. One of those places. I'll do some splatter effects. Too much, maybe. some orange. Table. So I'm going to dry it and then wet it and then do more. I kind of like it on her hair. Keep it there. Dried it a little bit, and I'm going to lift it a little. Thank you. dry. I'm gonna go grab my colored pencils. About the music. I also pulled up the reference photo, but I didn't have it near me. Amazing. Yes, amazing. Yes, important for the paper. Yeah.
Full press 9 by 12. XL.
Oh, sorry. I'll say that again. I have my mic on. I'm using the Canson, excuse me, XL watercolor paper. Paper.
Thank you.
I made her nose small, so I'm gonna correct that. This is ultramarine blue, Prismacolor. Now what? I'll get my sharpener.
Shavings everywhere. Not the sharp points. You know what? That's what it was.
That's what it was, guys. Now my sweet little doggy is curled up in the spot that I used to stream in. He wanted that spot for himself. He's so cute. And if you'd like to see him during the stream, consider supporting me. I'll drop a link here. Yeah, consider supporting me at coffee. Of course, it auto-corrected and put OK instead of KO. Let's see if it does it again. There it goes. Okay. So if you like supporting me at ko-fi.com/grayovercast, I'll be able to get a second camera to show you guys. That little guy. Well, he's not so little. Not so little. I mean, he's not the biggest dog either. And currently my goal is to see, I got shavings everywhere, see? Currently my goal is to get Arches watercolor paper and all the sizes I would like and hot press, because I found, this is cold press right here. I found the style that I like to do is better with hot press paper, especially with mixed media. It's just easier. I just like the looks of hot press anyway. My color palette for this ended up being orange, blue, and red. I'm pulling colors randomly. This one is Faber-Castell Matter. This is also a Prismacolor. It's pink. A little bit. I'm going to add watercolor on top. Now the oil from the pencil should repel it, but I just want to see anyway. And they're not watercolor pencils. They're just regular color pencils. Let's add a little bit more. Okay. not aiming for perfection here. I'm just playing around, having fun. And then as you do this, you know what you like and what you don't like, and what you can bring to a different painting. See, you can layer over top. Now, of course, it doesn't blend like watercolor pencils, but you can still work on top. All right, I'll see you Thursday night with another episode, stream. Thank you for watching. And to Thursday night is 10:30 p.m. to midnight. See you then. Bye-bye.